Micah chapter 1, working right along with the prophet Isaiah. He's over both Israel and Judah are still in the picture, but he is a prophet to Judah, and it concerns Samaria north. The word of the Lord came to Micah, the son of Moreshethite, in the days of Jotham, Ahaz, Hezekiah, kings of Judah, so it's dated, which he saw concerning Samaria, that's the northern Jewish capital, and Jerusalem, that's the southern Judah capital. So you're talking about the two capitals of Israel. They're split. Hear, all ye people. It's hearken to all. It's addressed to all. Hearken, O earth. So this steps out further than Jewish. And all that therein is. So this book is written not only to Samaria and Jerusalem, but the world. And let the Lord God be witness against you, the Lord from his holy temple. I wouldn't want God against me. I sure want to have a prophet come walking up to me and say, hey, you know what? I got a message from God. What's that? He's against you. That's trouble. For behold, the Lord cometh forth out of his place and will come down and tread upon the high places of the earth. Well, Jesus Christ did that with his footprints as a man. He's also going to do it again at the second advent. And the mountain shall be molted under him. Now that did not happen the first advent. So we are looking beyond ahead of when Jesus walked this earth, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, because this hasn't happened. Find me where a mountain began to melt, and the valley shall be cleft. Didn't happen. I don't believe any of those miracles ever happened. Miracles of healing and people possessed with devils. As far as I can remember, I don't ever remember no earthly world, this globe kind of sign. Storms, as wax before the fire, melteth, and as the waters that are poured down in a steep place, just flowing quickly, rapidly. For the transgression of Jacob, hear, all ye people, hearken unto the earth and all that therein. And let the Lord God be witness against you, the Lord from his holy temple, for the transgressions of Jacob. God say, hey, O earth, you look at my people. You look at my nation Israel. And you better beware. You know, the sins that Judah and the sins of Israel have done is going on today in religion. There's one God. And that's the God of the Bible, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, 12 tribes. They messed it all up. They're the one that perverted the worship of God and brought other God worship even more. For the transgression of Jacob is all this, and for the sins of the house of Israel, both north and south, and all together. What is the transgression of Jacob? Is it not in Samaria? Isn't that just the path prophets that we've been reading about? Those calves? The imitation worship that's the imitation of the true God and the true temple? Samaria is today would be religion. Jerusalem would be the true God. And God just said, listen, the transgression of sins lies in Samaria. Your religion is transgression. Your religion is a sin. And what are the high places of Judah? Are they not in Jerusalem? All right, Judah, don't go all holy on me. Don't go holier than now, because you know what? You got your problems too. You know, we are in a church age today. You better shut up. Ooh. Because you know what? When you boast yourself of what kind of church you are today, we are the church. I am a Christian of 2016. And you know how God describes me as a Christian? I make him sick. Revelation chapter 3. I am in the church age that makes God, I'm going to barf. That's me. That's my Christianity. I make God sick. And I need to repent and get right with God. All that I think I do for God, still I make him sick. The church age I'm in. And all the world to see it. Christianity today in Bible believers is a complete joke of the world because of how people have lived. And he's telling Jerusalem, listen, you're no better. King James Bible believing churches, shut up, you're no better. You got just as much sin as the other churches. You're not perfect. No one's perfect. Only Jesus Christ is perfect. Therefore, I will make Samaria as an heap of the field when they get destroyed and conquered. Heap is just a pile of rubble. And as the plantings of a vineyard, I will pour down the stones thereof into the valley. Stones in a vineyard would be for a wall. They would be for like a kind of well thing where they would stump out the grapes and make the wine. The stones would be a foundation. And God says, I'm just going to roll them down the hill. They're going to be no use. And I will discover the foundations thereof. Proverbs 24, verse 30. Excuse me. This will happen under the armies of Assyria within 100 years from what we're reading now. God's serious. And all graven images. You mean aids to worship? Thereof shall be beaten to pieces. Doesn't sound like God wants to keep them. And all the hires, Hosea 2, 5, and 12. Thereof shall be burned with the fire. And all the idols thereof will be laid desolate. God doesn't have anything good to say about images and idols. Never. Not one place. And all the idols thereof will I, God, lay desolate. For she gather it of the hire of a harlot. Tribal prostitution. Hi, baby. You want a good evening? Give me money. I'll go right to the temple to pay for a statue. Would you like to get money for the whoredom of this religion? We can give this money to your name of an honor of a hall or a window. I've been in churches. This window was paid for by. This seat was paid for by. This was given paid for by. Whoredom. You buy the religion by giving a plaque, so there's your name being spelled out. Don't think you're going to get any blessing from God when you've already got the blessing from man. Hallelujah, praise God, let's get right. And they shall return to the hire of... They're making money from sin. How's that? Hosea 2:5, Hosea 9:1, Isaiah 23:17. You mean you making money from sin? How would you do that? Spring break. Someone's got to sell them those itsy bitsy bikinis. Someone's got to sell them the booze. How about Bikers Week down here in Daytona Beach? You know, it brings commerce. It brings money. It's so great. It's so much a sin. Ask the police force. Ask the emergency room. How about gambling? City events for dollar signs. Making money off sin. Plain and simple. You just give it other names. Therefore, that's God, will wail and howl. Ooh. I will go stripped and naked. I will make a wailing like a dragon's and a mourning as the owl's. For her wound is incurable. Judah has been hit. Samaria has been hit with diabetes. And there's no way the wound's going to be cured. No doctor, no medicine, no treatment is going to heal that wound. And how did they get that wound? By having too much sweetness. Too much sugar in the messages. Too much sugar. You know, one of the places God said you're supposed to have salt? God said, as far as the salt, you're not to be lacking. But we sugarcoated the message. Now we're getting these wounds that are incurable. You know what a wound in the Bible, I'm not saying this is it, but you know another wound in the Bible that's incurable? Until God showed up? Leprosy. You start wasting away. You start losing body parts. You start losing into Naaman the Syrian. And then when Jesus showed up, only God can cure that wound. And God says, I'm stepping away. Go ahead. You do not have a curable wound. Well, that says a lot. A faith healer would say, well, they lack faith. No, my Bible says they're living in sin and enjoying it. How's that? As you make money fooling people in the name of faith in God, of course. For it is come unto Judah. He is come unto the gate of my people, even to Jerusalem. So Micah is not leaving anybody out. Declare ye it not in Gath. Don't go publishing what's going on. It ain't worth spreading. Weep ye not at all in the house of Ephraim. Roll thyself in the dust. Hey, the sins you're doing, shut up. Shut up. Don't go marching down the street saying we're gay and God loves us. Shut up!
Brought to you by Tonight's News at 11. We're going to have people who can use any bathroom.
Shut up!
We're going to celebrate the first sodomite.
Shut up!
We're going to legalize drugs.
Shut up! Put your newspapers away! Turn off the TV. Shut up. You're making it worse. You know what? God hears our television. God reads our newspapers. And all you're doing is declaring your sin more and more and hanging yourself deeper and deeper. Stop talking about it. Stop writing about it. Pass ye away, thou inhabitant of Sapphire. And I understand these names. I don't know. Having thy shame naked. Well, that's no shame being naked today. Not on television, not in a bookstore, Not in the magazine racks. There was a time that being naked in the Bible, it was a shame, and you ain't talking about complete naked. Their nakedness would put us to shame. Be like me going back and looking at 1930s, 1940s pictures of our great-great-grandparents at the beach. You would think, my God, they got more clothes on in the middle of winter. And still, some of that was a shame. Things have come the wrong way. The inhabitants of Zidnan came not forth in the morning of Beth Ezel. He shall receive of you his standing. And I don't understand. For the inhabitants of Maroth waiteth carefully for good. We want good. We want great. We want good news. We want peace. We don't tickle us. Give us sugar. Let us suck on honey. Let us have the Easter bunnies. Let us have the Christmas tales. Don't give us that hellfire preaching. Don't tell us we're going to hell. Don't tell us God is angry. We don't want that, Micah. But evil came down from the Lord unto the gate of Jerusalem. You don't get what you want. Thing they're doing. No, he does not. O thou inhabitant of Lachish, Psalms 20, verse 7. Bind the chariot to the swift beast, the quickest beast you got. She is the beginning of the sin to the daughter Zion. Ooh, beginning of sin. For the transgressions Israel were found in thee. And what they're relying on missiles and bombs and not prayer. They've taken their faith and hope away from God. Therefore, because you don't want to trust God, therefore, shall thou give presents to Morshur HaGath. You want to try it. What's those presents? Help! Come on, China, we'll give you, if you give us some money, we'll give you food, we'll give you electronics, we'll give you anything you know, please help us. Come on, Iran, listen, if we give you something like that, you help us out. Come on, Middle East, we need your fuel, we need your petroleum, we'll help you out, will you help us? How many nations came to the aid of Americans in the Revolutionary and the Civil War of America? How many nations came to help us, folks? Absolutely goose egg. But we go stick our nose in everybody else's business at taxpayers' expense. And no one has helped us, and no one loves us as a nation. They all want us down and dead. You want to go make a free living? Make your way to America. They'll take care of you. You want health care? Go to America. They'll take care of you. We can't do that here. Go there. They'll give it to you for free. Presents. They're seeking help from other people and not God. You know what you do when you go to religion? You bring him a present. And he'll give you some kind of prayer, some kind of candle, some kind of stupid thing. But I'll tell you what, I got the gift of God. And the gift of God is eternal life. And that's the only present I need. That's the only reliance I need. It's God the Father and the Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. I don't need this world and I don't need men because you know what? We're all sinners. But Jesus Christ is sinless. Jesus Christ is perfection. Stop relying on others. Get to God first. And God says, when you get to him first, all right, go see a doctor. Do it. Nothing wrong with seeing a doctor. You better go to God first. What, God can't heal? God can't take care of you? You're a nation and you're under God. And the first kind of battle, you go to ambassador. who don't believe in God? How did that work for Solomon? Marrying all those women. All he did is bring more temples and statues and all kinds of junk. The houses of Asubib shall be a lie to the kings of Israel. Lie about what? We'll take care of you. We'll help you. Treaties were made to be broken. Reliance on others can be a lie. Just because you say, I do, the death do us part, not always is so. God doesn't lie. And I can tell you the place that I got written in my Bible where it says God will not, cannot, is unable to lie. Yet I will bring a heir unto thee, an inheritance. O inhabitant of Mershiah, he shall come from Adullam, the glory of Israel. Make thee bold, mourning. I make myself bald. Do you know why you do that? You do it from, I'm a happy Christian, shave my head. Bible, that means you're mourning. And pull thee for the delicate children. That's weighing out the hair. Absalom had his hair pulled once or twice a year, and it weighed a certain amount. Enlarge thy baldness as the eagle. Totally bald. You know, when that Nazarite vow became ineffective, he was to shave his entire body. When that leper was to be healed, he shaved his entire body. For they are gone into captivity for thee. And Israel and Judah end up going into captivity. Israel first, then Judah later. And Judah gets three different chances of repenting and don't. So the next chapter, Lord willing, we're going to look at utter destruction. These prophet books are great, aren't they? Micah means who is like God. Oh boy, when we break this down in this book, who is like God? Well, God is not going to accept sin. God hates the sin, loves the sinner. Really? Then how come they're going into captivity? Why not God destroy all sin right now and let man live without sin? Because men love darkness rather than light, because their deeds are something.